Hello, yellow there, awesome boys and girls, and welcome. I'm Memo Master Kong, this is the devlog of the Nameless Ghibli project, and in today's episode we'll be taking a look at how the grass of the game came to be. Ah yes, the grass. The cornerstone of any beautiful, relaxing, peace-inducing, Studio Ghibli-inspired landscape. This one was quite the challenge for me, and I really wanted to get it right. So, as per usual, I found me some nice tutorials online. In this case, my thanks go to Lobe Yon Game Dev, who has made some really cool videos on the subject of stylized assets. You should definitely check out his stuff if you're trying to make something in this style yourself. So, in the end, how did my grass turn out? Did I nail it or fail it? Well, you'll kinda have to keep watching to find out. That's why I made this video. Somebody please break this awkward silence. Thanks for having my back, DK. Now, let's get into it. First, I started in Blender, cause we're making proper 3D grass here. Not some boring, crappy 2D alpha playing grass. Come on now, people, get your together, it's 2021. Just like with the rocks, this grass is very beginner friendly when it comes to the modeling. The main shape is super simple and there are only a few variations on it. Actually, the only difference between these grass leaves is that some are more bent than others. Next, I did some vertex painting, which is a property we'll need later to make the grass move in the wind. Simply put, the black part will not move at all, the red one will move a lot, and the gradient will make the grass slowly go from one extreme to the other along its length. That way, when the wind moves the grass, the bottom part will stay put, and only the top of the leaves will swing around. Once I got all the shapes and their vertex painting done, I simply put them together in the circle in a somewhat coherent way, and voila! We've got ourselves some nice grass. Before we move on though, we still have one more thing to do in Blender, and that's the LOD models. LOD, or level of distance, is a super cool technique that basically just refers to a simplification of a 3D model. We'll see all the details over in Unity in a sec. For now, I'll just say that I made two lower quality versions of this grass model, and then I just exported them along with the original one. Okay, so this is what we made in Blender, but right now it looks super boring and not like grass at all. So let's create a material for it using a variation of my Toon Shader. Now that we have some color, you can see that there's a nice gradient from top to bottom that's set with these two colors over here. We could go with something super wacky like this, but I'm gonna keep it plain and simple. Before choosing the colors though, I implemented the wind effect that makes the grass move around, and thanks to the vertex painting we did in Blender, the lower part of the grass stays in place. Over here, we can adjust the direction, speed, strength, and the offset of the wind. The wind direction is kinda self-explanatory. On the other hand, the speed will determine how fast the grass will wiggle around in the wind. The strength will affect how far the leaves will move, or rather stretch, and the wiggle offset will determine the starting point of the grass, which is where the leaves will go back to if the wind stops blowing. Again, I'll just go with something subtle like this, in order to have the grass move around gently. By the way, tell me down in the comments if you'd be interested in taking an in-depth look into the Toon Shader in a future episode. Shaders are obviously an essential component when it comes to the look of a game, or any 3D modeling for that matter. So, if you're interested in going over the graph, the settings, and getting into all the little details, just let me know. In the meantime, you can check out the first episode of this devlog, where I went over the basic features of the shader. And back to today's topic. Now that we have some good green leaves, I'm gonna duplicate these grassy boys over here, and also gonna make another version of the material with a slightly different color. This way, when we put them together, we get this super nice blend, which makes it less flat and much more appealing. With this, the grass is pretty much done. But before we move on, let's talk a little bit about the allotto. This simple but effective technique allows a model to lower its quality depending on its distance to the camera. When the object is close to the camera, its quality is high. But the further away the object gets from it, the lower the quality of the 3D model. Back in the day, Super Mario 64 was one of the first games to prominently use this on its main character. This is probably the Mario you remember from that game, which for the time was a huge advancement and was considered to be revolutionary. Sometimes though, during the gameplay, this nice model would get replaced with this monstrosity. This would only happen when the camera was so far away that the players barely noticed a change in the character. But yeah, this is what he looked like in the game from afar. Nowadays, pretty much every game does this, especially with assets that are placed massively on the levels, because it's a great way to free up some computing resources. Applying this to the grass, we get the following results. When we're up close to the grass, we'll see the high-quality model being displayed, so we get all the exquisite details. But as we move away from it and those details can no longer be appreciated that much, the model is replaced with the mid-quality one. If we move further away, the low-quality model will be rendered instead. And if we get really far away, it'll disappear completely. By moving these sliders, we can actually determine the distance range for each model and come up with something that feels just right. Okay, now let's go to our scene. Before I can start placing the grass, I have to do a bit of texture painting. This terrain was created using Unity's terrain tool, and in it, I set this grass image as the main texture. On top of it, I'm just doing some painting here and there to create paths and rocky areas. And now that we have defined our terrain areas, we'll finally start planting some grass. For this, we'll use the tree placing tool instead of going for the grass tab. Here we have a bunch of settings, like size, size randomness, density, size of the brush, and more. Remember that we have two grass prefabs, each of them with a different color. So first I start with one, leaving some empty spaces, which I then come and fill in with the other one. Also, when getting close to the river and the road, I decrease the size of the grass, so there's kind of a natural transition. And yeah, not much else to say about this. Let's just watch it take form. Okay, so this is what we've got, and for a long time, this is what the grass looked like, but there was something off about it, and I couldn't put my finger on it. You see, there were some empty patches like this one that looked weird, especially when looking at it from above. Then the other day, I finally realized what it was. I was going through some footage of Breath of the Wild when I saw this. Do you see it? It's a ground texture. The grass and the ground texture have the same color, to the point that it's hard to spot where the grass is actually growing from. In comparison, in my scene, it's possible to spot each individual grass leaf, and there is a clear disconnection between the model and the ground texture. To fix it, I just quickly went into Paint.net, made some simple color changes to the texture, and there you go! The difference is huge! Now we can even look at the grass from above, without it looking like a bald head. Yes, much, much better. Okay, so there you have it. This is the result of my grasp. Although I still feel there's some space for improvement, I really, really love the way it came out. So, at least for now, I'm gonna leave it as it is. Share your thoughts down in the comment section and tell me if you would have added or changed anything. And while you're down there, you might also wanna throw this video a like and subscribe to the channel. And well, if you're feeling particularly generous, you can also activate the little bell to receive a notification each time I upload a new video. It really helps a lot, because that way Uncle YouTube knows that you're liking my content. And of course, it's also gonna make me happy to know that somebody is enjoying my videos. That's gonna be all for today, but stay tuned. For the next episode, grab your paddles and grab your inflatable boat, because we'll be diving deep into the systems of the river and its visual effects. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye!